Public Affairs Broadcasting.
Special programming from Rockingham County Radio, rcrlive.com.
Good morning, and welcome to Community Accents. I'm Dr. Cindy Wall Sarwi, Executive Director of the United Way of Rockingham County. This morning you are going to hear from two of our special guests. One is our regular on the Community Accent Show, Ms. Debbie Moore, our campaign chair this year and United Way board member, and she's going to give you a campaign update in just a few moments. And we also have our special guest, Mrs. Angie Boles, Executive Director of Help Incorporated. So welcome, both of you.
Good morning. Thank you.
The United Way of Rockingham County is an independent nonprofit organization that works through community partnerships to make sure that our students are successful in school, to make sure that the basic needs are met in this county. It keeps our community healthy and safe, and it ensures independence and dignity for our elderly through 31 programs and services throughout Rockingham County. The United Way is not a top-down organization. The United Way truly is local people raising local money to meet local needs. Your dollars stay in Rockingham County. It is not governed by a statewide or worldwide organization, although we do have to abide by guidelines with Worldwide United Way and North Carolina United Way. We are an independently governed United Way of Rockingham County, so we make our decisions locally. And I wanted to emphasize that because a lot of people may hear of United Ways across the country or even within our own state of different organizations or different programs and services that they support. That is totally independent of your local United Way of Rockingham County. We make our decisions here in Rockingham County, and your money stays here in Rockingham County. The money raised for each annual campaign is allocated to human service programs throughout the community, with a small portion of the money targeted outside of the county. 95 to 98% of the money that we raise in any given campaign year stays here in Rockingham County. We do honor designations that go outside of the county, so if someone works outside of the county or lives outside of the county and they want their money to go back to their hometown or vice versa, then we acknowledge that, we abide by that, and we do send those designations outside of the county. And we also pay a small fee to Worldwide United Way and North Carolina United Way to have access to their marketing and training materials and be able to use the United Way marketing logo. However, the majority of your money, I want to emphasize again, stays local. Most of you have seen United Way advertisements, heard of United Way, and perhaps even participated in a United Way employee campaign. Many of you ask, will my dollars really help? Do they make a difference? And I'm here to tell you, yes, they do. And Debbie, you can emphasize that with me as well.
Absolutely.
But every dollar adds up to meet a need here in Rockingham County.
Exactly. And with United Way, especially this year, we are asking you to be heroes. Be heroes to your community. Be heroes to Rockingham County. And as of today, Cindy, I'm excited to say,
yes,
we're at $141,000.
Yay!
Yeah,
that's right.
I am just really, really pleased with that.
Yes.
We'd also like to thank Energy United out of Madison, because they have they've run their program, and we should be hearing back from them very shortly.
Mm-hmm.
Corporate gifts are coming in. We've got Newbridge Bank and Karistan Mohawk. Theirs have come in. And, you know, there's still exciting things happening every day with our corporate and our private citizens.
Absolutely, and we kicked off the Rockingham County Schools campaign, so we are daily going in and out of the schools here in Rockingham mm-hmm. County. We are excited that they're calling us to come do presentations to their faculty and staff, because the more people we can get in front of, the more we're able to give the United Way message and let people know where their money is being invested, because we do want to clear up any misperceptions of what people hear about. You know, every person has their own idea and own perception of nonprofits and philanthropic organizations, and we're just there to let you know where your money goes. United Way does not push anyone to give. We just tell you where the money is invested, and you can make your own informed decision of whether to support your local United Way or not. But if you have a particular affinity to a certain organization, let's use Help Incorporated, for example, sitting beside us. If you have a particular affinity to any one of our programs and services, you can always designate your money to go there if they are a partner and agency of United Way of Rockingham County.
Absolutely. And as Cindy said, if you do have you lived somewhere else and you want to send it back to your own community, that's okay too.
Mm-hmm.
We'd like for you to keep your dollars
that's
here
right.
with us.
Exactly.
But we are here to honor your wishes and your designations. And
that's right.
I do want you to understand, you designate. If you, it, like we'll use Help Incorporated, if you want your dollars to go to Help Incorporated's Freedom House, that's where they're going.
Exactly. And United Way of Rockingham focuses on three focus areas. We focus on education, health and wellness, and financial stability. So every one of our 31 programs and services fall under one of those three categories. And we closely look at each one of these programs and services. We have a committee that is called the Fund Distribution Committee or Allocations Committee, but they are assigned to particular agencies and they look at the financials, they look at the programs and services, and they make sure that your dollars are impacting lives in Rockingham County in a positive manner. They make sure that your dollars are staying local, that they're not being funneled outside of this county to help other people in other areas and other walks of life. We make sure that your dollars are staying right here in Rockingham County. So this committee is very vital. Our board of United Way of Rockingham County is very vital to the success of United Way and to the success of many of these organizations that we support. So know that the accountability system is here. We are audited. We just got through with our audit and had a very clean audit. We have consistently had a clean audit with United Way of Rockingham County, so we are abiding by the guidelines and ensuring that your money is being invested wisely. So I wanted to go ahead and make sure that I emphasize that as much as possible. One of our weakest links that I wanted to touch on is our retirees out there.
Absolutely.
And I say that's a weak link because we need to hear from you and we need your support. One of the reasons that we have a hard time reaching out to our retirees is that when we have employee campaigns in corporate offices or in businesses, when you retire, when these employers have people who retire, we have no way of getting back in touch with them because oftentimes when we have an employee campaign, you fill out the paperwork within your office, within your employer. So therefore, when you retire or you relocate or you switch jobs, we are not able to track that and we're not able to follow you with that. So if you have not heard from United Way of Rockingham County through solicitation, through emails, through letters, it's not because we do not need your support. We still need you, retirees. Please reconnect with United Way of Rockingham County. You can go to our website at www.uwrockingham.org. You can call our office at 336-342-7768. You can stop by. We will be glad to mail you information. We will be glad to bring you, deliver information. Anything that you need to make an informed decision of supporting United Way, we will be able to get that documentation and that information in your hand. So retirees, we still need you. You can be billed monthly, quarterly, however you want to set up. You can do debit transactions, credit card transactions. We have a number of ways that you can give, even a one-time check or donation through credit card. We can customize anyone's billing to meet their needs. So please, retirees, even those who work out there who have not had an employee campaign through their businesses, there is no business too small to support United Way or to have an employee campaign. We've been in offices where there are only three employees before. So please know that we can get you the information. Churches, organizations, civic, social organizations, we will be glad to come out any hour of the day, give a message, give a presentation, and let you hear about United Way and where your dollars go. And then, again, you make your own informed decision of whether to support the United Way. But we're just trying to get in front of as many people as possible.
Absolutely. And we want you to understand that we're not asking you to give more. We're asking more people to give. We want to grow our base of people that are giving. And by the way, there is no donation too small. We're happy to take a $5 donation, a $10 donation. You know, don't feel like you have to write a large check because you don't.
Absolutely.
Every penny counts when it comes to United Way dollars.
You're exactly right. And I want to give a shout out to Subway, Andy Strand of Subway of Rockingham County. He is our number one supporter. For years, several years now, he has given out free 6-inch subs, the coupons, to anyone who donates $10 or more. So you're pretty much getting your money back right there with the $10 coupon. So thank you to Andy, to Subway, for the 6-inch Subway coupon that you have given out to anyone who donates $10 or more. And another special shout-out I'd like to give out to MillerCoors and Williams Transco Gas Companies, who doubled the amount of dollars through their two events this year. MillerCoors had a 5K, 10K run. I think that was September 13th, somewhere around there. And then Williams Transco Gas Company had their annual golf tournament, the Rockingham County Fall Classic, and both of these companies matched every bit of money that we raised through that event, those two events. So thank you to both of those two companies for doubling the amount of dollars that we give back to the community. I want to turn it over now to Angie Boles, Executive Director of Help Incorporated, and she's going to tell us a little bit about, just starting off, a little bit about yourself, your title, and your role within Help Incorporated.
Okay. Thank you, and thank you for allowing me to be here. I always love to talk about, the work that we do here at Help Incorporated and how United Way and the community has really helped us do that work. We have the money that we raise, or the money that we get from United Way goes directly to the shelter operations, direct service. It's not administrative or anything like that. It goes to make sure that the residents there have 24/7 staff there to help them with their needs, as well as teaching life skill classes, transportation to different appointments they might have, food, clothing, just the basic necessities that they need when they're fleeing from a domestic violence situation.
Because often when they come to the shelter, they're coming with just what they have on their back. Is
yes.
that correct? They,
yes.
I mean, they don't have time to gather their belongings. They're just trying to escape danger and just get out of the house.
That's right.
The shelter, does it have a name?
Yes, it's called Freedom House. It was named by one of our first residents who stayed there. And she talked about how she felt when she walked through the doors, and that it was just so freeing for her, and a point in her life that where it was a new chapter. And so she named it, and it just kind of stuck. And so we're real pleased that, that we can give that to these people who are out there suffering.
Angie, who is available or who is allowed to be in Freedom House?
Anyone who fears that their life is in imminent danger from a domestic situation. It's an emergency shelter, so it's temporary. It's not temporary housing. It is an emergency shelter. So people generally stay, anywhere from, they may just spend the night.
Right.
But then again, they may stay, a couple of weeks, and sometimes even longer. There's really no set time limit that they can stay.
Well, I think my question, though, is it male, female, children? Because I know that Help Incorporated, I'm sorry, I'm on the board, so I we at Help Incorporated, anybody that's a victim of domestic violence, whether it's male, female, child, or elderly, we help. Freedom House only houses women and children, is that correct?
For
the most part.
For now.
For now?
Okay. Yes. I've actually been in some talks this week about how to transition our shelter to make sure it's safe if we do have a male victim to come in. So, it's changing. We're now, I'm glad it's changing. We're recognizing that it's not just women who are being abused. There are men out there who are being abused. And we've always helped, men and put them in alternative housing. But that's really not offering them the same service. So, we're trying to figure out how to make it comfortable for everyone. And the residents that we have in shelter at the time, before we allow someone else to come into shelter, we have to look at their individual needs and what their comfort levels are and everything else, because they are going to take priority. Not to say that we're not going to help somebody that calls in. If we have to make a referral to another shelter, we will. Or even do an alternative housing like a extended stay or a hotel room. It's a safe situation. I don't want people to think that we would ever, because that's what we're here for, is to make them feel safe.
Well, it's to take them out of the danger.
Yes.
Immediately.
Mm-hmm.
And then figure out what else to do.
Yeah.
It really is.
And it's a place where they can sit down with our staff and create goals for what they want to do. And the staff is really good, highly trained in case management to empower the clients there, the residents there, to make their own decisions, but also kind of show them the options that they may have given each situation. To what our biggest goal is to help the residents move out into a permanent, safe situation where they can be self-sustaining.
Right.
Which means
independent and on their own.
Exactly. Which means having a job. You know, and taking care of their homes and their families in an appropriate way without assistance. So
I've been impressed just through touring Freedom House, just through it's child friendly, it is family, it is conducive to all types of family, all sizes of families, very clean and nice and just very welcoming. I think no matter what age you are going to feel welcome going into there. So I think y'all have done a great job doing that.
Well, thank you.
And through your interpersonal relationships and referrals of working with other networks out there, like you said, if you can't house them in Freedom House, you have other options available to you just through your referral set, you know, network that you have out there. So I think that's great. And I know that you work well with people from other agencies and even other counties sometimes that y'all help each other out with that.
So we do. We do.
I think that's great. How many people can you house in Freedom House at one time?
We talk about the actual physical capacity of the shelter and then the staff capacity of the shelter.
Yeah, exactly.
Which are two completely different things. Because generally we just have one staff person there unless it's during the day, like Monday through Friday.
Right.
We'll have two. But on the weekends and at night, we just have one staff person. So we'd love to be able to expand because there really needs to be another staff person there. Mm-hmm. So staff capacity, when you're talking about people who come in who need transportation to appointments and things like that, and we have to keep the site, someone on site at all times, and we have the crisis line going there.
That's right.
You know, it varies. The capacity varies, but we have three rooms that are upstairs. One has five people, and the other two has four.
Okay.
And we also have, you know, the porta cribs, if we have infants. And then downstairs we have a room that has two beds in it, but one of the beds is like a hospital bed. That's our handicapped accessible room downstairs. We can house people who have the a physical disability, with no problems. So that's kind of the bedrooms that we have. Mm-hmm. But like I said, it depends on the family. Because if we have, you know, even three families in there who have a myriad of needs,
then
our staff kind of limits us as to what we can do. But we never turn anyone away who is in an unsafe situation. It's not like somebody calls and we say, oh, sorry, we don't have any room.
Right.
And hang up. That's not what we're here for, and I don't care where they call from.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, most of the people who call us are Rockingham County.
Right.
But if we got somebody from out of county because other agencies help our residents, we will certainly do the same.
Angie, is there any cost to the residents to be at Freedom House?
No, thanks to United Way and other donations and grants, no, there is no cost. They come in and the food, clothing, all of the services, even refer them to services at the main office, such as advocacy, therapy, that is open to them as well. And anyone in their family.
That was another question I had. What services are offered to these residents that are in Freedom House? Is it therapy and advocacy? And is there anything I'm missing?
Support groups.
Okay.
If it's safe for them to attend support groups. If not, we have the life skill classes and groups that can occur at the house. We have a community room thanks to Miller. Yay. A shout out to Miller for our community room. That was last year's volunteer project that they did for United Way. And it's an awesome room. It's got two computers. We have a table where we can have meetings and mm-hmm. the life skill classes. And it's also a reading nook where, moms and their kids can kind of relax. Mm-hmm. So it's just another nice space that we have, thanks to Miller.
That is great. And I wanted to emphasize and let the listeners know that the shelter is secure. It is, it is monitored. It is locked. It is monitored. It is a secure place. The address is not given out to the public. And the police monitor this house. So it is 24/7 a safe haven for victims and for their families to escape to. And I wanted to emphasize that. And I may be missing something in there, but I just wanted to make sure that people knew that.
Oh, yes. We have the security system that is monitored. Fire, police, the whole nine yards. We have cameras.
Mm-hmm.
There's a camera system in the office so we can see who's coming in. There's a dinger on the door. So, it is, as I tell clients who call in, it's the safest place you can be in Rockingham County.
Mm-hmm. Without being in jail.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Well, yeah. That's
right. Angie, what does it cost to provide these services per year? I mean, I know you can't give me an exact because, you may have 10 residents and then you may have 25 residents.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah.
Approximately, what does it cost to run that shelter for a year?
Last year, it cost us $230,000.
That's a lot of dollars.
Yeah. It is.
How does our United Way dollars impact that?
Well, the great things, you talked about doubling mm-hmm. money and doing those things. The great thing about United Way money is it is local money, so we can use it to match grants. So, if we have a grant that, requires a 25% match, we can use United Way to match that. So that lets us get even more money
right.
Than with it. So that's the main thing that it does. And it also helps us if we have expenses that, like our part-time staff that are there. And we have one full-time person devoted to the shelter and six part-time people. So that's kind of the staffing of it. And like I said, we need more or would like to have more. The good thing about our shelter is that, you have to be able to function in our shelter because these families have just come from a controlling situation. Yes, we want to provide safety, but we don't want to control them. We want to teach them, that they can make decisions on their own.
Mm-hmm.
And so you kind of walk that balance
right.
between, providing that safety and security and also empowering them.
That's true.
To move forward. To be at the shelter, we're not a group home. We're not a residential facility, like a homeless shelter. We're not mm-hmm. a homeless shelter. So it's we have to have people who can come in. We're not a substance abuse facility or, a mental health facility. Although some people may have some of those issues
mm-hmm.
that stay at our shelter, they have to be able to be independent enough to take care of their own hygiene and their kids
right.
and things like that.
What is the greatest critical need you have seen through your experience as Executive Director of Help Incorporated? What is the greatest critical need you've seen for this county?
Actually, one of the greatest critical needs is being met now, and that's transportation. I'm just so excited for the Aging, Disability, and Transit Services for taking on the public transportation piece, and they're trying to grow it as well. So I'm so excited about that because we have so needed that for this community, and our clients are taking advantage of that. Another critical need is just parenting.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I know that sounds.
I can see that. Yes.
Sounds kind of Well, and it's education. It's parent education. It's not that, you know, it's just about and support.
Right.
Parents need support in parenting. And I think a lot of us, me as a parent, you know, you don't want to you know, if you feel like if you reach out or you go to a parenting class or a forum or something like that, that you're not doing something right. Mm-hmm. And I would like to dispel that myth.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You need all the help you can get to parent. It takes a community to raise children.
That's true.
And we need to work together to dispel those myths. And what ends up happening, how it affects Help Incorporated, is it prevents child abuse.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's a preventative piece of that comes out of parenting class and forums and things like that. So just openly talking about frustrations and
right.
And issues that you have as a parent and being real and honest, because we've all had them. Mm-hmm. I think that is a great way that we could even reduce the services, because your child abuse, domestic violence, all of that is intertwined.
Mm-hmm.
And if we can reduce the
right
amount of child abuse and child witnessing the violence, which it, you know, also increases
mm-hmm.
it.
And it all goes back to basic education on life skills.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. And like I said, that myth that there's something wrong with me, I should
right.
know how to do this
right.
innately. No, you don't.
Uh-huh.
You
That's
know,
true.
Yeah.
Especially in today's world with technology taking over, no one can ever escape anything anymore, because
right.
it's 24/7, you know, technology
face.
In your face. So it's an overwhelming, it is so overwhelming, you know, so it's true. I think that has increased the amount of stress in people's lives as well. But
absolutely.
Just as a little heads up,
mm-hmm.
the western side of the county just approved the SCAT bus connection on that side of the county.
Yay.
So,
okay.
guys,
yeah.
before long, we're going to have SCAT buses running the entire circle of the county.
That's
so great. Awesome.
Yeah.
And with what you do,
uh-huh.
and I do, that is an awesome thing to
exactly,
know.
Exactly.
For all the partnering agencies.
For all the partnering agencies, this will be such a plus.
Yeah.
So
That's
I was
true.
Excited. I got the news a couple of weeks ago, but I haven't seen a press release on it, and I hope I'm not overstepping my bounds.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
But I was told the night we did
I knew
the
it was
millionth
coming,
meal,
but yeah.
And I was just so excited I had to share it with you guys.
That's
oh,
awesome.
Thank you. Yeah, we're excited
awesome.
About that. Well, in closing, you have just heard from Mrs. Angie Boles from Help Incorporated, Executive Director, about how United Way supports Help Incorporated, and about how your investment in United Way of Rockingham County helps support so many people under the focus area of health and wellness and safety in Rockingham County. And thank you, Debbie, for providing the campaign and helping
Absolutely.
Facilitate this conversation here. But know that your dollars do make an impact. They do make a difference in this county. We need your support. And if you ever have any questions about where your dollars go, please contact our office. Again, I will give you that information, 336-342-7768 or www.uwrockingham.org. We need your support. We need your investment. No dollar is too little to support your United Way of Rockingham County. And as you heard today, your dollars do make a difference in so many lives that you would never even know about unless we tell the story right here. So in closing, I would like to say, for the father who has lost his job and needs to put food on the table for his children, be a hero. For the mother whose son does not have insurance and needs medical care, make a difference in someone's life. For the elderly who can no longer cook for themselves and need a meal, give from the heart. For the student who is beginning to struggle in school, be a hero. For the family who has an uninsured loved one needing end-of-life care, make a difference in someone's life. And for the young mother who needs to escape danger for herself and her children, as you heard today, give from the heart. For the unexpected emergency requiring rescue services at home, at work, on the road, in the water, in the woods, be a hero. Please consider giving to your United Way of Rockingham County. Thank you.